sure.
You know what? We've been doing stand-ups all morning saying, we hope that when they see us, they'll stop.
Right. Oh, you know.
The only black folks out
there. Jamal, what? Jamal, you better tell her. Am I stopping? Every time, baby. Yes.
How are you?
I'm doing amazing. How are you doing?
I am too, now that you're here. I mean, my gosh, 16 Emmy nominations.
Amazing. Tremendous.
Well, really deserved.
Well, yeah.
But you know, this is a story that is still very much alive and well.
It is 100% alive and well. It has to be told, so if we tell the history, hopefully we won't repeat it. You know, if it's in our face, then it can be something familiar. They might say, you know what, we've been through that before, but let's not do that again.
Well, I would hope, although we know that it hasn't really changed that much, that the criminal justice system has changed slightly since then, which it has.
Right, it has.
It has. But it still needs to change in what many ways more?
A lot of ways more. You know, the main thing is about class. You know, if you are a millionaire, you know, you can virtually get away with murder. If you're poor, you might go to jail for 20 years for an ounce of weed. You know, and I've seen it. So we have to think about that when we're looking at these things. And this is a main touching point on when they see us. You know, this is a class, a race thing. It's a class thing. You know, these kids didn't have much. So, you know, they even though those attorneys were there to try to help them out, they got railroaded.
How do you feel today?
I feel very happy. You know, it's another project with Ava, you know, and Ava has brought me so many different places in my life. She's brought me to the Oscars, brought me to the Golden Globes, and now she's brought me to the EMMYs. You know, I'm just very happy to be a part of her world.